Hi everyone, thanks for having us. I'm Matthias Lüfkens. I'm an old-fashioned guy. I still have pen and paper. I'm really hoping to win that iPhone X. So I'm just a little hint to the organizers. So I don't consider myself an influencer. I'm with the PR agency Burson Marsteller, and we're working with traditional media, but also influencers. My little claim to fame is I have a study which is called Twiplomacy, T-W-I-plomacy, where we're looking at how heads of state and government are using digital media from Twitter to Instagram and Facebook. You can find that at twiplomacy.com, and there's also a Twitter account at Twiplomacy, which I'm very proud of because it only has 53,000 followers, but 2,200 of them are verified followers. And I'm very proud to say that I have 200 heads of state and government actually following this account, and I do send them occasional direct messages. So I think that's kind of another way of looking at influence. I have my personal social media accounts, but they're, I would say, in comparison to your crowd here, rather small. And I do have to say I consider myself rather a happy Instagram husband because my wife, she's actually a bit of a social media celebrity and she's a Lonely Planet writer and a travel writer for the Daily Telegraph. So you can actually follow her at Tripalong. She'd love that. But I'm very, very pleased to have with me here next to me Melanie Martins. She has, at the last count, that was last night, 1,890,022 followers on Instagram, 1.2 million, Facebook over 600,000, and something like 76,000 on Twitter. Sweet, and I even looked at your Pinterest account. A couple of hundred there, But what I really like about this, so this is wow, it's like 1.8 million or 1.9 almost, wow. But you know what? It's not the numbers, of followers that is really important. What I think is absolutely amazing, her Instagram posts, on average, have an interaction rate of 4.8%.
Wow. Now, you're educating me. I didn't know that.
Did you not know?
No, I didn't.
So no, I think I that is actually...
I'm going to use that. I'm gonna
that is an it. Absolutely brilliant figure. On Facebook, I looked, the interactions since the beginning of the year, you had 2.8 million interactions on your posts and videos. With an engagement rate of 2.5, and the engagement rates, especially when you're a big star.
Yeah, it decreases a lot. You start losing a lot because Facebook wants you to pay all the time. They're saying, oh, those guys have money, let's go. And basically, even if you're a subscriber, even if you're a follower, you really, as an influencer, you almost have to pay Facebook just to reach your audience. So you have to find creative ways, tell to your followers to have the notification button so they can see your videos, they can see your content. Otherwise, if they don't, there's not the notification so they can see you, Facebook simply doesn't show your content to your followers. So that's really a big issue for influencers and followers, to see their content, because now Instagram, Facebook are decreasing the engagement rate. Yeah.
So I just want to read your profile. You're 24.
Yeah.
We're allowed to say this because it's on her Facebook profile. You're blonde.
Yes.
A stylish globetrotter, polyglot, Frenchie, jet setter, diver, vegetarian, sunset catcher, dreamer, pacifist, positive vibes only, and a matcha tea.
Oh, yes, matcha
lover.
Tea, of course. Matcha
so
tea.
I really want to know, how did you start? How did this happen?
Oh my gosh. This was 3 years ago, I think. 3-4 years ago. So, first of all, my content is based on travel. So, like Johnny, I love traveling. So, we got very well together. he has been, he did everything. I'm still on my way, but we have 10 years different. So, I did 43 countries so far. But I think it's what Johnny said, resonates a lot with me. It's really about the passion. It's really about being free. When I grew up, I didn't really know what I wanted to do because my professors are always telling me what kind of jobs you want to have. And I didn't know really what I wanted to do. I just knew I wanted to be free. Exactly the same way Johnny said. It's just exactly this feeling. You want to be free. You want to wake up and feel inspired by the journey, that what you're going to do today. And when I saw like all my friends, they becoming accountants, becoming lawyers, my parents wanted me to do law school. They want me to go to law school. It's like there's no option to law school. I go. So basically, I didn't really know, because at the time when I was 15, you have to understand there was no really Instagram influencers. It was not really something very, very new. But it was already in me. You know, it was the passion for doing my own thing, not really following what the others will be, having this 9-5 job. That wasn't really, I knew it wasn't what I wanted. So even if everyone was like, no, you have to do this path, my heart was saying, no, there's something else for you. So I will say around 22, after starting really to travel quite a bit, my boyfriend told me, Melanie, what about you simply, instead of just writing a personal diary for yourself, what about doing it digital? What about having a website? What about having an Instagram platform? What about converting your Facebook profile as a Facebook page and sharing what you're sharing for you, but for everyone? So then that's how really I started. So I brought my passion, that was a hobby, which is traveling and creating stories, and I brought it online on digital.
So what was more important, the blog or the social media presence?
Well, here's the thing. I started my blog because I really like to post a lot of editorials, as I call them, editorials, where I have like 20 to 50 pictures. You cannot really, post 50 pictures of one travel on Instagram, one day, like, here's 50 pictures, that's too much. But I really like the fact that on the website, you can really express yourself more. You can really show the entire journey, what you have been through, which on Instagram, you cannot really do that. It's really selective pictures. So it complements each other. There is not really something. I started to focus a lot on the website in the beginning. Then I realized I have to be present on Instagram, on Facebook more, because this is where actually people spend more their time. They spend more their time on mobile apps such as Facebook and Instagram and Twitter, rather in websites, So this is where the audience is, and this is where you have to be present to get your audience and to increase your audience. And then if they want to know more about you, if they want to know more about your journey, you have the website. And this is where they can learn more about your personality, about your struggles, about, the journey, which trips you did, what happened there. So this is where they can really get the insights. Instagram is more about, an overview, and Facebook also an overview of what's happening.
So what was the post or the picture or the video that made you become a star?
Well, I don't think there's no overnight success. I think it's really starting 3 years ago, working every day, doing partnerships every day, So I started really to collaborate with brands when I was maybe, I will say, 30,000 on Instagram. And I started to travel. At least everything was complimentary, so I didn't have expenses. I could create content. And I will say one of the moments that really made me think, wow, is when I organized a meeting with my fans in Morocco. So I was going to Morocco for the second time, and it was actually for Christmas. It was Eid on the same day. And I was flying from Rome, and I had a meeting at 3 p.m. In Morocco, in the Sofitel, which is the hotel I was going to. And the flight gets delayed. The flight gets delayed of 5 hours. So basically, I arrive at the hotel around 10 p.m. And the meeting was at 3. And then when I arrived at 10 p.m., everyone was still there, waiting for me. We had like around 100 persons, people who traveled 8 hours of car, from the mountains, from the Atlas, from really far away, in every side of Morocco, and they come to see me and to say hi and to take the picture and ask me, how I'm doing. And when I saw those people waiting for me outside of the hotel, like more than 5 hours just to say hi, they give me gifts and sometimes, cookies that their mom did and everything, I was like, wow, I can't believe that. There was like a little girl, she was, I think, 13 years old. She came with her parents. And she came like straight from Marrakech, and I was in Rabat, and this is like 5 hours, trip. So really seeing that this little girl was inspired and she was so motivated to see me, I was, that was that moment I thought, oh my gosh, that's exactly what I want to continue to do, inspiring people, make people, going to see me, and they wait for me to see me and talk to me. And I was, since then I did the same in Egypt. I was in Cairo And I did the same meeting with my fans in Cairo in the pyramids.
And we've seen you yesterday in the refugee camp.
Yes, exactly, in the refugee camps. I really try, you know, always to be with people, to interact with them. If I don't speak the language, I'm going to find a way to interact with them. I think social interaction for me is really important.
So what content works best?
The content that works best is everything that gives you that gives positive energy to the followers and to your audience. So I will say when I'm smiling, when I'm happy, those are the contents that works best. If I have a picture when I'm not in there, you know, in the picture, I will say this picture doesn't work as well as if I am in the content. So if I am in the content having fun, for instance, with a jet ski in Abu Dhabi, for instance, this is the kind of picture that people want to see. You know, they want to see happy people because it's energy is contagious. If you have a good energy, if you have a good vibe, it's contagious, you know?
Talking about that picture, I've actually looked at your entire Instagram feed. That post is a sponsored post.
Yes, exactly. So I was actually working with Abu Dhabi Tourism, so they invited me for 3 nights. But all the creativity, all the content was on my own. So I'm the one who said, if I want to take a picture with a jet ski, that's my one thing. There's no one is telling me, you have to go with a jet ski and you have to go around and take the picture. You know, this is like my boyfriend and I, we work together and we think, oh, wait, what about, you know, doing the jet ski? Because I love jet skis. So he said, you never shared anything about, you know, this hobby that you have of jet skis. So let's take a picture with a jet ski. And I was having fun. So it was, you know, very spontaneous moment. But I try really to have always spontaneous moments, nothing to, how I can explain, nothing to fake, you know what I mean? Just something that I don't like to plan too much. I want go with the flow, see what I'm doing today. If I am diving, we take nice shots because I'm diving. If I am in the beach, we take nice picture on the beach.
So can we say you choose your customers or?
a bit. Yes, and my content. I think it's more about the content. Okay. I really want to be the one picking the content. I don't like when brand says, we're going to provide the photographer, we're going to provide you the clothing, we're going to provide you the script. I don't like this, you know. This is when they do that, this is more advertising for their campaign and not for my platform. That should be for their platform, not for mine, you know.
Great transition over to Gamze. You're with Danone Waters,
yes.
Famous for Hyatt Water and Evian and other brands.
Yes. Straight
question to you. You've been working with traditional media. You're working with influencers.
Yes.
What is easier to work? Who is better to work with?
I think when you look at research, really, when the brand talks about herself or the brand itself talking, consumers don't believe it anymore. So it's like 80% say, I mean, this is just BS. So, but when an influencer talks to them, and that influencer is really part of their tribe, community, then it's like, oh, they really start believing in that, and they start using your brand. So when we look at research also for return on investment, it's 1 to 3 for influencers. So we do use a lot of influencers in our campaigns as well.
Do you have an idea what the mix is currently between traditional media, TV?
I mean, radio? In Turkey, it's much different than what it is in Europe. Because today, although the 40% of the population is below age 25, still, TV is like 51% of the spent in Turkey. So it's much less in Europe and everything. So we do have to have some media traditional kind of reaching the consumers. But at the same time, we're shifting a lot of our budget onto digital and to influencers. So it's really changing.
So what are you looking at in, when you decide which influencer to take? Would you take Melanie, for example?
Lovely, which I looked into your accounts before coming here. Basically, let me on this kind of draft how we look at the whole campaign and everything. Beforehand, we were just going traditional media, one message, everybody. So this has really changed now. We're more like using the precision marketing methodology, which is like we look at our consumers based on their lifestyle and interests. So it's no longer like 20 to 35 housewives with one kid. That has really changed. But more like sports colleagues or the people who are working in the plazas. You know, these kind of different segments with people who really have different interests. then of course the brand has an umbrella positioning. But how we reach these people is very different, with the tonality and the different way that would interest them, we bring our messages to them. And we use the medias, of course, they would be in. Like the sports people, we look at influencers who would really influence these people more. And before working with an influencer, that was the question you were asking me, we look at their, I mean, their statistics. So it's not just how many people follow them, exactly. But more important to us is the engagement rates. And also we ask for their statistics. We see, also we look at the previous works they've done and the effects of it. And then we decide which influencer to work with, really.
I was thinking, Melanie, would you accept product placement?
Yes, I have done product placement. But here's the thing, it has to be something that I will personally use. So not something that I will not use and then the brand comes, oh, I know you will never use that, but here it is, take it, you know, just take a picture. No, 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 it has to be something that I will definitely use on my day-to-day, and I think my audience will also use it. Otherwise, there is no point. You know, there is no point to do a campaign just for the money. There is no point of doing something if you don't believe in it. Yes. Otherwise, you're going to be known as a sellout. You're going to be, your followers are thinking, oh, she's just doing it for the money. She doesn't care about us. Why we should care about her if she doesn't care about us? So everything that I have been doing when I work with brands is because I know my audience. First and foremost, I know what they like. I know if you know what kind of destinations they're looking for. I know what kind of hotels they're looking for, what kind of lifestyle they have. So it's really about knowing your audience and knowing, does this product make sense for them? Will they really use it? Will they like it if I am using it? So, you know, I'm a vegan, for instance, and they know that I have a very healthy lifestyle. So it wouldn't really make sense for me promoting something that goes against my values and who I am. That's something that, you know, I will definitely not promote.
You know, because I just, you know, floated that idea to Gamze. You know, what about you, your pictures, you know, you will always hold a little water bottle, a Hayat water bottle, an Evian water bottle.
Well, I mean, Evian water, I mean, Evian, I drink Evian, so
that's
I drink, and I'm French, so, you know, that's, so, yeah, that will make sense. That's not some, you know, it makes sense because it's water, it's healthy. Evian, it's a, I grew up in France, so we drink Evian at home, so it's not something that, you know, I just discovered the brand, and I'm like, I'm not sure if I will use it, no, because I definitely use Evian, so no, it's not a,
so
I will,
let's talk,
I will
let's
work.
Talk about numbers. How much would it be, you know, how much does Danone have to pay? Ooh. To get you
having
a, just a little bottle, you know.
Yeah, I mean.
Can we do that behind the doors, please?
I mean, it really depends on everything. It depends on who is the
They do
brand.
Have money.
Thank you for the insight. Now, it really depends of what they're looking, of the post. It really depends. Usually it's by package. It's a digital package. Because as I think there was someone that said... they said basically it's not about one post, it's about a long-term relationship. And I think also the same, it's not really about one post. You really want to share your passion to your followers about the brand that you're working with, and one only post is not going to be enough. I mean, we know perfectly the engagement rate has been decreased. If we really want to have real results, you need to have a digital package, which means maybe 2 to 4 posts per month, you know, something constant, not only, you know, like one just per year, you know, it has to be more constant. In terms of pricing, it's, you know, it really depends. I cannot say like one price for everyone. It's something we negotiate with the brand, we see what they need, what kind of platform has to be used, if there is Insta Stories. It's an entire package that we discuss. It's not only one picture.
So our story is less important than the main Instagram feed or...
The Instagram feed is very important, so that's why I want to have my own creativity and I want to be the one creating the picture, because it has to be exactly my style. It cannot be someone who takes the picture and it has nothing to do with what I am doing. Otherwise, this will be more, I will say, an advertising for their own platform. You know, they can do that. We can basically have an agreement where I will be the face of, you know, the campaign and they will take the pictures for their own platform. But I want also to be able to give my little twist, you know, on the campaign for my own platform if I have to be using the pictures and the content for my own platform.
Have you already refused clients?
Oh, yes. I refused a lot of campaigns because they had everything prepared for me. And I had to obey basically every situation. And I had to say stuff that I was like, no, that doesn't make sense. I'm not going to say that. It was just too fake. You know, I don't like it. I like to say really what I think. It has to, you know, if I'm talking to Insta Stories, my followers, they have to be, okay, that's cool. You know, that's the reaction I want them to think. I don't want them to think, oh, okay, she's a sellout, oh my gosh, okay, next. You know, that's not what I want. I want them to think, oh, that's cool, yeah, what about this brand? Really, that makes sense. But not the opposite, not like, oh, I don't, well, you know, I don't want to afraid them, no one.
Do you have an editorial calendar?
Yes, I do have an editorial calendar. I use an app. Which is basically to planify everything. And for instance, if I do campaigns for a tourism board, okay, we say there is maybe 2 pictures per day. So this is a digital campaign that we're working on. And those 2 pictures, I decide, you know, what is going to be the most entertaining for my audience to see. Will they prefer to see just a landscape or will they prefer doing, you know, seeing me doing something fun? So I take several pictures and then I really choose the ones that I believe will entertain and inspire more my audience. So in the beginning, I was, for instance, posting landscape, and I see that they will definitely prefer more me with the landscape. And they tell me that all the time. The landscape is amazing, but without you, it won't be the same. So you know, they make these little comments, and I read a lot of comments, because I think comments are really important. I not only read them, but I answer them. So if they have questions, they know I will answer them. And I saw a lot of influencers who are on the same level in terms of following, but they have less interactions. And when someone make a question, they don't answer. Never, never answer. And I saw someone commenting on an influencer, and she just said, I was thinking to make a question, but I know you never reply, so I'm not even going to bother. And I was reading it because she's one of my friends, and when I saw that comment, I was like, wow, I don't want that on my platform. You know, I want people to make questions, and now I will answer them. I want them to know, okay, I'm making this question because I know she's going to reach back to me. I don't want them to think, oh, she's a pretentious girl with, you know, with 1 million followers or whatever. No, I want them to think she's a normal person. She's having, you know, she has this lifestyle. I like to follow her because her lifestyle is great. I can learn, you know, a lot of things, you know, where to travel next. The products that she's using are things that I believe it's useful. I believe it's stuff that are okay. They have, you know, with proper brands. That's what I want my followers to think.
Great. Gamze, where do you see the whole marketing going? I mean, you know, here, this Inflow Summit has been going now for 3 years. This is the fourth summit. Where do you see the influencer marketing going?
It's going to even improve and get more and more. That's how I see it. But the most important thing here is actually what you said, several things, which I really loved. It has to be very authentic. Yeah. I mean, it has to be very real. It has to be really a part of your life. When you're promoting it, it shouldn't sound like you're really marketing it. And as long as, and also when brands and the influencers work together, if they can work together like partners, so yeah. As a brand, we would never dictate anything to an influencer. So I really empathize with what you're saying, but it's because you know your followers, you know what is needed there as well. So we do take advice from our influencers as well, and that way collaboration will really lead this forward in a much better way. And I really think there's a lot of use. It's going to be, the marketing budget is going to shift more and more to influencers. That's how I see it.
I realize there is only one selfie on your Instagram feed. And so you don't really do selfies to engage the crowd, no?
No, I don't really do a lot of selfies, that's true.
You actually have your Instagram husband here somewhere.
Probably somewhere.
We have to mention him because Because seriously, you know, there's so many influencers. You couldn't do it without the better half behind the camera.
I take a lot of pictures with him. I try to get him because he doesn't want to take pictures. Very shy. But in Abu Dhabi, when we managed for the campaign, I managed to take a picture with him. It was a dinner under the stars. So I managed really to have a picture with him on the dinner set. So that was really, really lovely. Now, I don't really like to do selfies about just me because it's not about me. It's about the journey. It's about the lifestyle. It's really about inspiring people. Every time I'm posting something, I always have a comment that to motivate them, you know, to do the same or to that nothing is impossible. If you really want to, you know, as Johnny, my parents didn't have any money. I grew up without traveling. All my friends were traveling. And I had, you know, similar background with Johnny. And that's the reason why maybe we are here, because those struggles make today our strengths. That's why we are maybe who we are. So the selfie, I'm not a regular girl who just wants to take selfies. Say, oh, how beautiful I am. That's not my goal. You know, of course, I'm going to have nice outfits, which I think is going to look great on the picture. But it's a combination. It's the outfits, it's the location, it's the landscape. You know, it's everything. And that's exactly my brand. That's how I want to position my brand.
If you don't follow her yet, follow her, Mela Martins blog on Instagram, Facebook. Absolutely amazing
Thank
picture.
You.
I'm trying to bribe her. Because on Pinterest, she said she loves dark chocolate.
Oh.
So I brought her
yes,
some
true.
Chocolate under one
and
condition. We're
going
to take a selfie from the stage here with Gamze and everyone here.
Okay.
And I know you didn't bring your phone onto the panel, but I would love it if you then, you know, kind of maybe you share it, I'll send it to you. If I dare you, you share it on your account,
Thank Gamze. You.
This is for you.
Thank you.
So let's do this group selfie with everyone. Can we have some light on the audience
no,
there?
That's so cool.
Sorry. Can you put more light on the audience? You guys are important. We'll just Gamze come
yes,
in there,
I'm trying.
Landscape or vertical? What do you guys prefer?
No. Landscape maybe.
Landscape. We get more of the crowd in there.
Yes, I think
can we have
so.
Some light for the crowd?
Ooh.
3, 2, 1.
Yes.
Thank you.
Great. Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you so much. Thank you.